Today we're going to be dealing with pagination, but before we get into that, I want to do some cleanup. First of all, I want to create a route. Well, we have the route already, but I want to create the link in this sidebar. So if we head back to the text editor and we open up sidebar. Okay, and we have this route for roles. We can now just change this to href equals route roles, or actually it's admin roles index. And now that should point to that route, that roles page. So if we go back and refresh, we can click tables, roles, and now we'll be able to go to that roles page easily. Okay, fantastic. The other thing is that we don't have any validation for our update. So if we go edit, there's no validation in there. Okay, so it'll just go ahead and do it. So if we go to our role controller, we can basically just, we'll just copy this and then edit it accordingly. Okay, so this validate, since we're updating it, we don't need unique. We'll keep that permissions required. We don't need that. We can keep that. We can keep that, and it should be good. Let's go ahead and check that out. So go back, refresh, and now if we go to edit, and let's say we get rid of this and this, we should get that validation. So permission field is required. So we'll go ahead and add, you know, one or two new ones. Edit. Okay, fantastic. So now that's been updated and we're good to go. So now we can go ahead and start setting up pagination. So let's go up to the top where we're displaying it. And now in here, we can just put paginate 5. Okay, and now in our index, role index, right here, we just need to change up a couple of things. So if we go up top to where we're displaying them, let's say roles. So in our v4 loop, now we have to change this to data, and we can close that. And then if we come down here, we'll need to change this roles.data. And that should be good. We should still be getting it, but let's go ahead and refresh and make sure. Okay, now if we go ahead and check our inspect, we want to make sure that we're getting the correct information. So we'll open up our view. And an index, let's see, roles, we're getting roles.data, and this is our paginated, these are the same roles, but now we're just getting 5 at a time. Okay, and now we have our links, and now we can use those to create pagination. Okay, fantastic. So now let's go ahead into the text editor. And how we're going to set this up is by creating a component. So it'll be a pagination component. And this way we can use it in various pages that we have, because we're going to have several tables where we'll need the pagination. So pagination.view. Now, there are a couple of different ways of doing this. This way that we're doing is how I decided to do it. If you look online regarding the pagination for Laravel 8 and trying to bring it into Inertia, there were some different articles about maybe putting it in the providers and creating a brand new length-aware pagination thing and putting it into the app service provider, or even doing it through the Inertia middleware right in here. I don't see a need to do that. There's no reason for us to do that anymore. I think that was just initially when Laravel 8 first dropped, but as of now, we don't need to. Okay, so how we're going to do this is we're going to create a template, a nav. We're going to have a UL with the classes of pagination, pagination small, margin 0, and float right. And these are all Bootstrap classes. We're getting it from our, if you take a look at the template that we're using, this is what the pagination will look like. Except we're in dark mode, so these will be dark. Let's see, back to our text editor. And now we can say li with a class of page item. Open that up. And in here, we're going to be bringing in some props. Okay, and because this is going to be a dynamic component, we need to create props that are going to be used across the board. So what all of the pagination links are going to have are links. So that's what we're using. So now in this pagination, in this page item, okay, we're going to bind some classes. And we're going to need some brackets in order to set that up as an array. Okay, so the first one will be the link URL, because again, we took a look at the browser. Okay, and we open up view. That's how we're getting these. In the links, we're going to be given the active class. It'll be false for the first one, previous with the URL. The next one will be true, because it's page one, and then it'll have the URL in here. This is just Laravel's pagination that we're leveraging in here. Okay, so link URL equals null. If it equals null, it'll be disabled. That's the class we want on it. And if not, then we'll just leave it empty. Okay, and for the link active, if it's the link active, we'll have the class of active. So if it's not null, else we'll just leave it empty. Okay, then under here, we're going to need a V for to loop through all of the pagination links. So for link index in links, under here, we're going to have a key. And that's going to be index. And then right in between all of that, we're going to have our inertia link. The class will be page link. Then we're going to need to bind our href, and we'll just open that up for now. Okay, so in here, it'll be link URL equals null, just like we did up here. Okay, so if it equals null, then we're going to leave it as if it was a hash. And if not, then it's going to display the link URL. Okay, and we're also going to use vhtml, and then we're going to just show it as the link label. Whatever the link label is, it's just going to make it as HTML. And that's going to help us out because, as you can see here, we have the NLAQUO, which is just a little arrow symbol, the left arrow symbol and the right arrow symbol. Okay, so this is just making it a bit easier for us. So let's head up to our text editor in the where we have the page pagination links. So in here, we're going to go ahead and put that component, which is pagination. Pagination. Okay, and then we need to pass in the links. So links equals roles links. Now let's go ahead and import that that pagination component. Okay, so copy paste pagination. And this I want to move down, and the folder is actually components. Okay, fantastic. So now let's go back to the browser. We'll refresh. We don't need this open anymore. Okay, scroll down, and now we have our pagination link. See, it's disabled here. We can click 2 for the second page. Fantastic. So now this we can actually click because we are not on page 1 anymore. Okay, so now let's do a quick run through and make sure we have our validation. Okay, good. And we'll come down here and make sure we have our validation here. Okay, so we don't have any permissions. And as a matter of fact, we need to change that for the user because we put this as required, but the user doesn't have any permissions. So one thing at a time. Let's go down to where do I have? Okay, so when we open the modal, we can go ahead and add this clear errors. And also when we close it, so this clear errors. So that'll be the first thing that we fix. Okay, go back and refresh and make sure that that works. Okay, so we'll try it this way, create, and we're not getting anything. So I think that, yeah, this should be form clear errors. So we'll do that for both of them. So now let's go ahead and try it again. Now we'll try create. Okay, we're getting our validation. Great. And now let's try to edit. Okay, and edit. Okay, and so the errors were clear, and we're also getting the permission here. I think I'm going to change that, though. But now our validation errors are gone, too. So I think what I'm going to do, instead of leaving the user permissions as empty, I think that what I'm going to do is, let's see, migrations. Where's our roles and permissions? Right down here. I think instead of just leaving it empty like that, I'm just going to put it as NA for now. You know what I mean? So default, we'll just say NA. Okay, and now let's go ahead and reseed all of that. So PHP artisan migrate fresh seed, so that this way the permissions aren't empty and we can still keep our required. Now, if you're deeper into a project, you can just add that later on, like add that as another field. You don't have to do it like this, but considering this is just a demo project, it's okay to do it. Okay, so let's go back to our other terminals. And we'll have to log back in, so refresh. Okay, so admin at admin.com, password. Okay, now if we go down here. Let's check that out. Oh, I think I know why. Let's see. Roles. Data. And that's the fifth one down here. Let's see. Permissions. Okay, so let's change it in the seeder. We're going to come in here. Roles and permissions seeder. And we'll go up to user permissions. We'll just say copy, paste, and for this we'll just say miscellaneous. Okay, so permission create, and this one will just be NA. And the description will be NA. Okay, so admin permission 2, so miscellaneous permission. Okay, so now we'll be able to create that permission. Admin, super admin. User create. And so we can just copy this one and then just change it. So copy. Paste, and so now user role, sync permissions, miscellaneous permission. Yeah, I think that's okay. Or did I not make a user role? Okay, let's do it like this. Copy. Paste. So now this will be user role. User role. And the permission will be miscellaneous role. Or permission. Okay. So now that's good. So user, sync roles, user role. And we're also syncing those permissions. Okay, so this I think I can get rid of. No, I'm going to leave it there because when we're not going to be creating users really or setting up the registration or anything. But if you do, then you can just give them that. Okay, or you can sync it. However you want to do it, it's fine. Okay, so now we can close this. We can close. I'll leave that open for a second. And then let me check on the user table. And this will now be where ID equals 5 first. Sync role. Just a quick edit from the future. When I seeded the table, I forgot to add the permission to the users that we were creating in the user table seeder, these 50 users. So they didn't quite get the permissions, but I went ahead and fixed it after I had finished recording everything. So now I'm just adding it here. So now if you go and take a look at the database, you'll see that now the permission ID, which is 15, okay, now the users actually have it. I just wanted to point that out before I finish the video. All right, well, let's give it a try. Okay, now let's go back, refresh. Then we have to log in again. So admin at admin.com password. Okay, so let's scroll down. Okay, great. So now we have that as our permission. Why don't we go ahead and open up the database and see if those users also have that. Okay, Admin-O-Matic. Model has permissions, model has roles, permissions. Okay, so that is a role. I mean, it's a new permission with a new description. Fantastic. Okay. Okay, great. So now that our validation is done and everything is pretty much done in the roles index page, we can go ahead and start working on the permissions in the next episode. That's what we're going to be setting up, and we're going to be doing it the same way that we basically did with the roles. Okay, so I'll make sure to push all this stuff up to GitHub. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.